Hello everyone, myself Shweta Shah and I am your instructor for the subject Microprocessor and Microcontroller. In this subject we have started Unit 5, that is AVR Programming in C. In this session we are going to see today the topic, that is Timer 0 Programming. Okay, in last session we have seen the what is timer, and there are total 3 timers are available, timer 0, timer 1 and timer 2. From this we are starting with the timer 0 in this session. So let us first see these steps to program the timer in the normal mode. And to generate the delay using timer 0 in normal mode, we have to follow these steps. In first step, we have to load this PC and T0 register, that is the timer and counter register, with the initial value of the count and which we are going to be incrementing by 1. Okay, so first you have to load the value of count in the TC and T0 register. Then you have to load the value into TCCR0 register, that is the timer or counter control register, which will decide which mode you are using, whether you are using the 8-bit or 16-bit, whether you are using the prescaler or not. Okay, and when you select this clock source, the timer and counter starts to count, and each tick it causes the content of the timer or counter incremented by 1. Okay, so first you will load into the TC and T0 register the count value, then you will load the control value in the TCCR0 register, and then it's at each and every clock your count is going to be incremented by 1. To keep monitoring this timer overflow flag, that is TOV0 flag, and to see if it is raised to the FF value, and we get out of the loop when this T0V0 becomes high, and it will become high when your count becomes FF. Okay, so you have to monitor this TOV0 flag, that is the timer overflow flag. Then you have to stop the timer by disconnecting the clock source using this following instruction, like LDI R20, 0x00, and then send it to the control register, that is the TCCR0 register, by using the instruction out TCCR0, R20. This will makes the value of this control register as a 00. So all values of this control register will be 0 and the timer is going to be stopped. Okay, and then you have to clear the timer overflow flag for this 0 timer for the next round. Okay, so by this way you can take this step, and then for the another counter you have to go back to the step number 1 and repeat the same steps again. Okay, so this way you can use this timer and counters for the timer 0. First you have to load the counter into TC and T0 register, then you have to load the control register, that is the TCCR0 register, then you have to each and every clock your counter is going to be incremented by 1. You have to monitor this timer overflow flag for the timer 0, and when this becomes high you have to stop the counter, and by using this value of 00, by loading this into the control register, you will stop this timer. Okay, and then lastly you have to clear this timer overflow flag so that you can use this for the next timer. So these are the steps for using this timer in the normal mode. But here we have the one question, that how to find the value for the counter which we are loading inside the TC and T0 register. Okay, so if you assume that if we know the amount of time delay we needed, the question is that how to find the value of this resistor, this content that we require to store inside the TC and T0 register. And to calculate that value to be loaded into this TC and T0 register, we have to follow this steps. Like first we have to calculate the period for the time clock that we are using. So we are given the time period, we are given the clock, then we have to find this its clock period by using T clock is equals to 1 divided by F time. Okay, then here this F timer is the frequency of the clock that we are using for the timer. For example, if we are not using the prescaler, then this F timer is equals to F oscillator divided by T clock, and that this gives the period for which the timer is going to be incremented. So whenever we divide this desired time delay by the clock period, it will say how many clocks we will need to create this count. Okay, and lastly we have to perform the operation, that is 256 minus n, where n is the decimal value that we got in this step number 2. Because our counter is going to be incremented by 1, and when it becomes 255, or you can say FF, at that time your flags, that is TOV flag, is set. Okay, and we require to set that flag at particular time, at particular count. So we have to use the count value depending upon that. So we are subtracting here that value from the 256 and using that value as a counter, incrementing that value as a counter. And this, to convert the result that you got in this step number 3 to the hex number. And this hex number is the initial value that we require to load in the TC and TC load register, that is the timer register. Okay, so our value of TC and TC load will be like XX that we got in the hexadecimal form. Okay, so this is the step by using which you can find the value of the counter. Now let us see the example how we can perform this operation. As here in this program, we have to assume that the XTAL, that is the clock frequency, is the 8 megahertz, and we have to write the program to generate the square wave with the periods of 12.5 microseconds at the pin number 3 of port number B. Okay, so we require to have the square wave which has the time duration of 12.5 microseconds. So it includes the both of the duration, on time as well as the off time. So whenever we are creating delay, so we have to make the on and off for the some duration, and that duration is the divide by 2 of this clock period. Here the clock period is of 12.5 microseconds, so we require to make this pin, that is the port number 3B's third pin, as a on for the half duration and off for the half duration. So what is the half duration? That is the 6.25 microseconds. So we have to make this pin as a on for 6.25 microseconds and off for the 6.25 microseconds. Okay, so here we are given the frequency that is of 8 megahertz. So the time duration will be like 1 divided by 8 megahertz, that is equals to 0.125 microseconds. And that is the duration for the one clock. But how much delay we require? We require 6.25 microseconds for on time. If we consider only the on time, okay, so we require 6.25 microseconds. Similarly, that value for the off time. So we will create the delay of 6.25 microseconds and we will call it whenever required, and in between that we will write the code for the on and off that particular bit of port B. Okay, so here we have the time duration for one clock as a 0.125 microseconds and we require to create the delay of 6.25 microseconds. So we have to have some value of count. That value will be like, we have to divide this required duration with the our time duration. So it will be like 6.25 microseconds divided by 0.125 microseconds and it will give us the 50 clocks. So we will require total 50 clocks for creating this. This is the value for the count, but actually we have to have this value subtracted from the 256. So we will have the value like 256 minus 50, that is equals to 206. And if we convert it into the hexadecimal, we got the value as a CE. Okay, so we have to load the CE value inside the TC and T0 register whenever we are designing the delay. Okay, so this is the value depending upon the given crystal frequency. Now let us see the code for this program in which we have to make the on and off. Actually we are generating the square wave, but ultimately we are going to make this pin as a on and off for duration of 6.25 microseconds. First we have to load the stack counters, and that is going to be done by this in stack. Okay, then we will load this number inside the register 16, that is 0 × 8. It will make this third pin, three number pin of this port B as a 1. So here we are using the data as a 0 8, because it has a bit pattern 0 0 0 0, then 1, and then 3 times 0. Then we have to set this particular bit of port 3 as an output port. So we have to set that bit by using the instruction SDI DDRB, 3. It will set the third number bit of port B as a set. Okay. So it will make this port as an output port, and then we will load the 17 register with the contained 0. So here we are using 16 register number 16 with the contained where your third bit is 1. And using 17 register where you have the third bit as a 0. So that is the toggling of that particular bit. Okay, so this is the pattern for this. Now we have to send this to the port number B. Now we are sending that to the port number B. So we are first sending 0 to port number B. Then we are calling for the delay. Then we are doing the operation EOR, that is the XORing of the content of two register, that is R17 and R16. What is the content of register 16? That is the third bit is 1 and R17 is 0. And if you do the XORing of 0 and 1, you will get the result 1. So you are storing that 1 inside the register 17, and next time you will send that 17 to that port. Okay, so we are using the instruction out port B, 17. So your 1 is going to be sent to the port number B. First you have sent it 0, then you have sent it 1. Now you will use this jump, R jump begin. It will jump to this begin, then call another time delay. At this time your register 17's value is 1 and you are doing the XORing with the 1. That is the third position. 1 is at only third position bit. Okay, so you are doing ultimately XORing of 08 and 08. So you will get the result 00. So at that time you will send the 0. Then another time you will go to the begin, call for the jump, then do XORing of, at this time XORing will be of 01. So result will be 1. So ultimately you are getting the toggling of that particular third bit of that port. Instead of using this code, you can also use the bit pattern for the 08 and 00. So first load 08 and send it to the port number B3, then use the 00 pattern and send it to the port number B. You can use that thing also. Okay, but this is the something different we are using with the programming. Okay, now let us see the delay. In delay we are loading the count value in the TC. First we are loading inside the register 20 and then sending it to TC and T0 register. Okay, so you are first loading the value of the count. Then you have to load the value for the control register, and in this we are using this timer 0 in the control mode, and for this data will be like 01. So first we will load inside the register 20 and then we will send this register 20's content to the timer and control for the 0 timer, that is TCCR 0 register. So this is the loading value for the timer and counter, and this is the control for that the particular. And then we have to use check the flag, and that is, that flag is inside the TIFR register that we have seen in the last session. Okay, so first we will load this TIFR register into the register 20 and then we will compare whether this bit is 0 or 1 by using this instruction, that is SBRS R20, TOV0. This will check the particular TOV0 bit of the register 20, or you can say 0th bit of register 20. If it is set, then it will skip this next instruction, that is the R jump again. Otherwise it will execute this instruction R jump again, and if it is executing this instruction, then it will go to here. For another time it will check for the flag, and another time it will check for this value whether it is set or not. If it is set, then it will skip this and jump to the LDI. Otherwise again it will execute the loop. Okay, when your bit is set, at that time you have to stop the timer. So at that time you have to stop this timer by using this, loading this 00 inside the control register. So first we will load the 00 inside the register 20 and then send it to the timer and counter for the 0, control for the 0th timer. Okay, by using this instruction out TCCR 0, R20. So it will stop the timer 0. Then we have to clear this TOV0 flag so that you can use this timer for again, and for this we have to reset this bit, and by using this instruction we can do is LDI R20, 1, and this is the time for the shifting, and that is T0V0. That means you are shifting this for the 1, and then sending this to the TIFR register, that is your timer interrupt flag, and it will clear the flag of T0V0. And then return to the main program. So this is your subroutine for the delay. This is the delay part, and this is the main portion where you are toggling that particular bit, and this is the delay portion where you are using this particular counter for creating your delay. Okay, by this way you can use this program. Let us see the another example in which we have to use the frequency, and then we have to find the value of the counter. So here we are given the value of frequency as a 8 megahertz, and we have to generate the square wave of the frequency of 16 kilohertz instead of the frequency that is given in the previous case. The port is same, just the value of the count will be changed. Here the frequency for the square wave is like 16 kilohertz, so your time duration will be 62.5 microseconds. And from this, half duration will be on, half duration will be off. So your 31.25 microseconds will be on time and 31.25 microseconds will be off time. So we will require the count value as a 31.25 microseconds divided by 0.125 microseconds. This 0.125 microseconds is the time duration for this 8 megahertz frequency. So we will require, we will have the counter value is 250. And that is we require to subtract from the 256, so the value will be 6. So you have to load the 6 value for the counter in the TC and T0 register for this example. You can use the another concept, that is the prescaler, for generating the larger time delay. And this is the prescaler circuit that you have to connect with the timer 0. Here you have the 3 selection and 8 input. This is the basically 8 cross 1 multiplexer with the 3 selection. Here you have 0 input, here you have clock input, clock divided by 8, clock divided by 64, clock divided by 125, clock divided by 1024, and that is the T0 inverted and directed. And you are providing this as a value to the timer 0's clock source. Okay, so this is the basically clock for your timer 0. You are selecting any of this, and for this you have 3 selection. If you are using 00, then first value is selected 01010, then your second value is selected, if selection is 011, then your this 3 is going to be selected. So you can use this prescaler to generate the larger. By using this prescaler, your clock duration will be larger, and using that larger duration, you can create the larger delays. Here we are given one example in which how to find the timer's clock frequency and its period for the value of area based system with the following frequencies like 8 MHz, 16 MHz and 10 MHz. We are told to have the prescaler of 1 gen 60. So we are using the frequency divided by 64 network with the oscillator. So whatever your frequency is providing, it is going to be divided by 64. Okay, so I am providing 8 megahertz frequency, so my ultimate frequency will be 8 megahertz divided by 1 by 16, that is equals to 125 kilo. And due to this, my time duration will be like 1 divided by 125 kilohertz, that is equals to 8 microseconds. If you are given the frequency of 16 megahertz, then your duration will be like 1 divided by 16 for the 16 megahertz, that is equals to 150 kilohertz of frequency, and time duration will be 1 divided by 150 kilohertz, that is equals to 4 microseconds. And similarly for 10 megahertz, we will get the value of 614 microseconds. Okay, so you can use this kind of prescaler structure. This is the timer zeros bit control bits, and we are going to using how we can set this prescaler. By using this bits, that is here, the selection is over here for these 3 bits, that is D0, D1 and D2. If you have no clock source, the particular clock you are having, clock divided by 8, clock divided by 16, clock divided by 256 and so on. By using this pattern, you will put these values inside this TCCN register, that is the timer and control counter control register, and by using that you can set your prescaler. So let us see one example how we can set this. Here we have the value of TCCR0. If we want to set the programmer timer 0 in normal mode with the prescaler of 64. Here we are using the timer 0, so we have all other values as a 0, but for the prescaler of 64 we have to use this value. For prescaler of 64 we have the value of last 3 bit as a 011. So we have to put this value as a 011. And depending upon that, your pattern will be like 0 and 3 rather than 00 that we have used in the previous case. So you have to put this value for indicating that we have used the prescaler with this frequency. So here we are ending our today's session. If you have any query, then you can contact me.